So after the women's doubles second round affair there we've now got a men's doubles second round as Fang Jianmin and Li Shengmu, the number 10 seeds, take on Hun Tianhao and Mohammad Zachary Latif of Malaysia. This is another interesting matchup because the 2007 champions, Marcus and Kido, they withdrew from this side of the draw. And that was who they would have been expected to meet in the next round, the last 16. The winner of this match now will meet Wei Hong and Yexin of China, likely. Both these pairs will probably fancy their chances against. And this is going to be an interesting matchup. Of course, we've got the number 10 seeds here. And that's the Malaysian pair coming through. Hun Tianhao and Mohammad Zachary Abdul Latif, who saw off the 2005 champions of Bak and Gunawan in round one. There are the Chinese Taipei pair who had a bye in round one, but have had a few disappointing results of late. And the way that we saw the Malaysians playing yesterday, Morton, they'll fancy they can cause an upset again. They're not being seeded, but they think they can come under the radar and maybe make some good progress here.
Yeah, as you say, it's an interesting match. It will be a match when you look upon it from a European point of view, you would say, oh, they play fantastic because they are playing the same game. And obviously they would challenge one another on the same things and it would look absolutely fantastic. And then when they get to play a different style, it will be completely different. So we're going to go in, I think, for a big bang. This is going to be attacking game, flat game from the word go.
And they've met twice before and it's one win apiece, which says it all.
I would believe that, yeah.
Yeah. Here's the Malaysian pair there, who are the fourth best Malay pair. But they've been picked ahead of a couple of others. There's been a lot of talk about should they have been picked, shouldn't they have been picked. But the coach's decision, I suppose, vindicated by their win against Bak and Gunawan, of course, former world champions yesterday. Teamed up last September. Hasn't been a great pairing. And they were pondering their future together. But they got the call to be playing in the world championships. So they were surprised as well. And, well, they're trying to make the most of it.
Yeah, it's really funny because I was the coach of Malaysia in 97 to 2000, and I picked those two into the academy in Kuala Lumpur, so I know them pretty well.
Okay, well, give us a little bit of insight then.
They're lovely kids. They're really good guys, and they are very playful, very playful, and you can see it in the game as well. Especially Zachary, I think, is. You know, he's very skillful and he can play any shot in the book at any given time. Sometimes it's just too difficult for him to choose which one to use.
And he's you know, World Championships, he's won bronze before, you know, with a different partner.
He's a very good player.
And of course, the other player, Hun Tianhao, he was former World Junior Champions with Tan, who's now, of course, with Ku, and they'll be going for gold as well in this men's doubles.
Exactly. But I still say that. He looks, in my book, a little bit unfit, but he's still very quick and play really well. But I'm sure he would benefit from a little bit of physical training.
So what about this Chinese Taipei pair who, you know, seem to play hot or cold, really?
Yeah, but that's the style. That's how they play. I think we saw them in Qingdao in the Sudirman Cup when they played Denmark against Morgensen and Bo. And they beat them in three sets. And they really, really, really played well.
But since then, they've been poor. You know, they were beaten the second round of the US Open by Smith and Worf. They were the number one seeds in that. To losing the second in their second match suggests. And, you know, also they were number one seeds in Canada. They only got to the quarterfinals in that. They haven't produced the results that they'd have been looking for ahead of these World Championships.
No, but as you say, they're hot and cold. But I really fancy them. I really specifically find Fang very interesting. He's forward. He's going for everything. He's moving into the net all the time.
Wojciech Owsowski and Suzanne Taylor are the two main judges here, the umpire and the service judge. The Chinese Taipei pair wait. I mean, you look at their form in 2010, they were fantastic. They won three rents in a row. They won four times an Indonesian Super Series. They won both the Canadian and US, which we just talked about there, where they didn't perform well. So they can do it. They they could, you know, potentially win here this week. But
I think they are a really fantastic pair, but they got to hit the day. I agree with you on that. But if they do, they play well.
So they're a pair that could win the whole lot, or they could go out today.
Yes. But I think that says a lot about men's doubles these days. There are many, many good pairs, and the consistency of the pairs is not great. So anyone in the top 10, I would say, could win.
Service over, one love.
There's Hun, who just wants them to go out there and believe in themselves. The coach has been telling them to show no respect.
And see, that's what I mean. That's Zachary in a nutshell. Those two shots, you know, not many would do them, and he just loves it. He's challenging it straight away.
Well, he yesterday
look at that, look at that one, and then cross again.
I know he was the one yesterday against Bakken Gunawan. He was playing those shots. He was the difference between the four players.
He was. He's really inventive.
Great creativity.
Yeah. As I say, sometimes you can't choose which one to use, and that's the problem. Ankle. That's really well played. Very good ankle, very good surprise.
Yeah, Fang Chiam in here, giving the Chinese Taipei pair a slight advantage at the start of this opening game.
Service over, 2-3.
Really been playing some good smashes, Fang, from the baseline here, the last few points. Again, another winner.
Plenty of pace and power in it as well. And that smash from Fang. Not too bad here from Hun Tianhao as well.
Yep, hitting well.
Set over, 3-5.
They never let them off the hook. The Chinese Taipei pair really went into the net and closer and closer and closer. Yeah, well played.
Service over, 4-6. 5-6.
Terms again now.
This is a poor shot. Obviously looking to see if it was too long, but still.
And now they lead. One go, Lee, was he? Like a rock wire.
No, he was moving his way in there. 7-0. Well, I think Lee has played quite inconsistently in the beginning of this this match. I think he's played not the best shots and made some easy errors and so on. So, you know, he's got to play himself into the match. Again, a very difficult shot play by Hoon here. The next one here is really nice. Look at that disguise. He's actually going a little bit over it, and then everybody would expect it to go either cross-court or into the center of the court. And here it goes straight down the line. Really well played. Good deception.
Over 10-8.
That was very, very passive play from Fang, I think. This is passive. It's not really trying to do anything about it.
And it's Fang and Lee who give themselves the opportunity of trying to take this first game with the interval lead. Not really much between the two pairs here.
No, it can go either way.
The fact that Marcus and Kido, who I mentioned would have been up next in the third round in the last 16, that they've withdrawn, it really has opened the gap for one of these to step through to.
Definitely, but I'm sure it's not playing on their mind. They're so focused on trying to win this match that they really do not consider what's going to happen.
Not now, but I would have thought in the build-up, this is an opportunity.
It's an opportunity, but I'm telling you, every player, every pair have to focus on the match right at hand, because if they don't do, they're out.
11-8.
So, yes, they can see the gap, they can see the possibilities, but they're so focused on winning this more than anything.
Service over 9-11. Thank you.
So the first couple of points since the interval have gone Ian Howe and Zachary Latif's away. It's Ku and Tanner here, the number one pairing from Malaysia. But all the hopes in the men's doubles rest with them, and of course with Lee Chong Wei in the men's singles. I suppose the biggest surprise is we haven't got any women singles players from Malaysia here this week.
No, since Wong Mewtwo has stopped playing, Malaysia has been suffering a bit in the ladies' singles. That's well played by Zachary. Very hard to get past him at the net.
Service over, 11-12.
That one is really well played.
Set up a winner for Hunt.
But again, you know, it's the same style of play as what I said in the beginning, and we haven't seen any blocks in the defence. Everything is hard drives, flat stuff, everything. Smash and flat, smash and flat.
As a coach, Morton, would you want them to mix it up, or you've got to say, just play to your strengths?
I would mix it up. It's too simple. Obviously, it sounds really ridiculous because you see badminton at such a high level. But I think from a tactical point of view, they need to have more variation if they want to go all the way to the top.
It's finely poised, as we expected it would be. Error on the serve.
Service over, 13-12.
I think what he was asking there was, did it hit him?
Yeah.
He got it in between his legs.
We will never know.
Service over, 13-all.
Good, it was in.
14, 13.
Very good length. I think it's hitting the line.
Your thoughts were right.
Yep.
Oh, that one was just long.
Service over, 14-all.
Always difficult, isn't it, to leave it again when you know the last one hit the line?
Yep. It takes a bit of courage.
Yeah, good judgment there. And again, well judged.
15-14.
Thin line, isn't it, between success and failure sometimes?
Good smash. Seeing the gap, playing it.
Service over, 15-16.
Yeah, he packs a punch, doesn't he, Hoon?
I think the beauty is that, you know, he's so many attempted just to hit as hard as they can and not think. He's hitting really well, and obviously he's spotting the space as well, so which is really good placement.
As he did again there. Mm.
16-0.
Wow, this is turning into a fascinating encounter, isn't it?
It could be 3 times 30-29.
You're tempting fate there a little.
It's just like yesterday when Chen Long, he lost to the player from Guatemala. the first few shots there, and it was really good play and all that, and then I said, okay, now it's just going to last another hour like this, and that's what happened. So you never know.
Yeah, a little error here. Well, you say error, it caught the net right at the top of the net. It was close to being the shot he wanted to play. Going for the line, just failing to hit it.
Yeah, it's out. It's a good call from the line judge.
Service over, 17-18.
They were hanging in there a little there, the Malaysian pair, but the mismatch from Fang means they take the points, and that was the difference between leading by one or three.
Yeah, and it's a massive difference. See, that's why I say sometimes, you know, he's rushing forward and then he's playing this flat that one there. Imagine if he's just blocked it. And they would have had a nice attack and all that. And here they put themselves in trouble.
That level pegging again. Lovely disguise. Brilliant drop shot from Zachary.
That's what he can do. The kind of play he can produce. He's got all the shots in the book.
And what a time to produce it. Edge ahead. 2 points from taking the opening game now. Game points.
20 game points, 9-18.
And the surprise pair, the Malaysian twosome, who weren't rated by too many back home. On the verge of the opening game here, but on the back foot in this rally.
Never getting out of it now. Not. They were almost out of it.
The door was shut.
Service over, 19-20.
The dispatching the winning shot. One more game point, though. Brilliant tenacity from Fang and Lee there, because I think there was a moment in that rally where the Malaysians thought they played the winning shot. But it didn't come, and now we're level pegging again at 20 all. We're into extra points now. Someone has to win by two clear points.
Unless they get to 29 all.
As predicted by Morton. Oh! That's out.
That's over. 21-20.
Game points again. It's their third game points.
Oh, that's well left.
Yeah. Particularly given it could have been game point the other way. Out of the reach of Zachary there. Three game points saved.
It always reminds me of when we used to play, you know, so it's out of reach.
Yeah. fourth game point.
Set over, 22-21.
That was the coach, Malaysian coach from Indonesia, Rexy, Rexy Meineke.
His brother's on the Korean team, isn't he? The Korean men's doubles team. As a coach, I think, yeah, there's a bit of competition between the brothers.
Could be, I'm actually not too sure, but they're actually mini brothers. I think they're five or six brothers, and they're all involved in badminton. So.
Well, four times they've had the opportunity to take this opening game, four times denied by Fang and Lee. And you're showing great mental toughness here.
Yep, on our way to 29-all.
Well, fifth time lucky, maybe.
Yeah, I don't know if you have a saying like that, but
I've just used it. Do now.
Yeah. But it just shows again how difficult it is to serve. It's the point go with the receiver the whole time, if you notice.
Yeah.
So it just shows the point of how difficult it actually is to serve. Kind of pressure you on the right from the beginning of the rally.
Quick serve. Yeah. Is it this time? Oh, well retrieved, but not enough. Put away by Li Shengmu. Just that little bit of indecision allowed the Chinese Taipei pair to get on top.
Zachary really wanted to kill it. He was hitting as hard as he could two or three times. And then trying to move in on the net, but they managed to get it over him.
23-all.
On our way to 29.
First time then in this opening game. It's a game point to Fang and Lee. Saved it. As if I should stand water. Another 10 points to go, and we're at 29-all.
Let's see.
Time for a little breather. A deserved little breather.
Chances are not great for 29-all. So it's just a bit of a joke. Let's see.
Doesn't happen often, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Points in this opening game.
24-all.
Gotta have nerves of steel, haven't you?
Service over, 25-24.
Long and Fang Chiamin and Li Shengmu come through in this opening game 26-24. Well left by Fang. Great relief as well to see it drop long. Yeah. 23 minutes on court for that opening game. Really hard now, isn't it, for Kunti and Hao and Mohamed Zachary Latif to just pick themselves up and put that disappointment behind them.
Yeah, normally I would agree with you, but especially in this pair, I think they're very spirited. They really fight all the way. Every time I see them play, they never give in. They do their best and try to come back in. I know when the Danish pairs are playing them, they actually hate to play them because they just keep at it and keep going. And you know, sometimes they just get a little bit of a small chance and they take it and they win. So we know that they are a very good fighting pair.
5 game points though they missed out on there in that opening game.
Yeah.
But as we mentioned at the start, you were talking about the Sudermin Cup when they played against Boa Mogensen.
Yeah.
They don't shy away from marathon matches, these two, do they?
No.
That was well over an hour.
They fight. I think, though, that, you know, if they get under pressure and they really get pushed, sometimes it looks like they haven't got answers. And I think that's what happens when they play, like, as you said, in the US Open and the Canadian Open. It's not going their way. Suddenly they don't have the answers. Where, you know, when they play well on top, you know, they play
second
like fire.
Game, Lovell, Lake.
Well, that was a good sign of putting disappointment behind you from Moon here. Nice disguise on the drop shot. Right through the middle from Lee.
Service over.
Good smash. That would be a typical shot from Sakri here. Obviously, he's unlucky. It's going out, but again, it's executed so well.
Service over to all.
Good interception of Fang on the third shot.
Service over, 3-4.
Wasn't happy with that, and that's very understandable, but he was playing it from too low. This is a too low position. You've got to go up there, push the pace.
Dominating at the net there, Lee.
Yes, definitely. Really well worked by Lee. Good smash there,
six,
and then
four.
Suddenly the surprise in there on the forehand side of Hoon. Really well played.
Yeah, it looked a little slow to out there, Hoon. Is it just that he was
caught a little bit by surprise? Yeah, they can't afford these serve mistakes.
Yeah, that's two in this game now.
It is. And now the 5 points for the Malaysians. Big percentage.
Six all.
Judgment for
seven over, Schumann. 7-6.
Not an easy one to call that one, was it?
He is not happy with that one, Sakri. He thought he could get away with that, but no ways. No ways. Look at this. Look at that. He's trying to play. No, it was seen from the word go.
Service over, 7-8.
Placed on the forehand side of the body.
Service over, 9-7.
That's first one, second one.
I'm surprised they need a new shadow after that last rally.
But none has been over 300 yet, has it?
No. Giving Lee a little bit of a taste of his own medicine here.
And again, it's noticed that it's on the forehand side of the body where the mistake is coming in the defense. What I'm looking for is these more soft shots on the defensive side. Here you see the lift, and then he's trying to play the soft shot but can't really control it. And because of the fact that they can't control it, that's maybe why they're always pushing it.
Set over, 10-9.
Another 11, one for the statistics. Again played in. Look at this mesh. It's coming up now. Look. Again, forehand side.
And he tried to play it backhand.
Yeah.
So once again at the interval, it's Fan Chiumin and Lee Sheng Mu who have the slight advantage. But you wouldn't want to call this game quite yet, would you, Moon?
No, definitely not. Three times, 29.
Court 1, 20 seconds. 20 seconds. Yep. Court 2. 11-9. Late.
It's been thoroughly enjoyable. There's been plenty of entertainment. Lots of hard hitting between these four players.
Service over, 10-11.
Been very tight throughout as well, which is just added to the fascination of watching who's going to come out on top.
I think there is actually a nice variation here. Look at the block that's coming from the net now. Look at the block. That's the one, that's the one. Rather than pushing it back to them, the block is coming.
Seen a lot of that, haven't we?
Yeah. It's interesting. I think the tactic these days in men's doubles is that obviously you go on the attack, but sometimes you also have to have the nerve to give the initiative away in order to take it back again. Because if you just keep smashing and smashing and smashing, the defense on the other side is so good that they eventually get in on a counter-attacking situation. So you attack and then suddenly you give it away in order to take it back. And that's what happened here.
It's about when to do it though,
exactly.
Isn't it?
Service over,
13-12. After working so hard to win that previous point.
Yeah, and then serve
in the net.
Yeah. Be happy it's not under the old scoring system. Shot again from Sakri. That's the creativity we see from him. This is the shots he can play. And probably the only one of the four that can really do shots like this. I'm sure Rexy must be quite happy with that.
You wouldn't know looking at him necessarily, I suppose.
No, he's not giving anything away. I think it was really well played by Hun there, but Sakri was too late to see it, and therefore too late to move in the net and had to lift it. But it was well played. Now it comes here. This is nice. Sakri is too late getting up at the net and covering the net. Don't do that. He's waiting for it.
Service over, 15-14.
Well, it's another game that's swinging one way then the other. Every point's a crucial point.
Yep. Not the best of shots.
Service over, 15-0.
Got punished straight away. Look at that. Going cross court now. completely open court.
Possibly six more points for victory for Fang and Lee, or maybe 6 points for Hoon and Zachary to take us to a third.
Again, it was good to see the change in the smash here from Zachary. Normally they go for the body, normally they go for the centre of the court, and suddenly he goes for the tram lines and hit a winner. That's a very good variation again. Well played.
Well, is this their opportunity? Down at the interval, now 2 points to the good. Of course, they had 5 game points. What an opportunity that was.
It was, he wasn't happy. He missed it.
And if we look back at this point in, as a pivotal moment.
That won't be forgotten.
How frustrating is that for everyone in the Malaysian camp?
Yeah. This time Rexy couldn't hide it away.
Go! Service over, 1970. Oh.
And that's three of these since the interval.
Yeah, can't afford it. And the last two serves, the Malaysia's been fought.
Yeah, 19 all now.
Again, look at where it's finished, it's on the forehand side of Zachary. There we go. That's a very clever variation. That's really good serving.
And it's match point.
It's excellent serving. Been serving low the most of the time, and then suddenly this flick serve is coming in. That's really well played. Clever, clever.
And just like that, it's match over. The Malaysians trying to say it was out, but it was good. And Fang Chieh-min and Lee Sheng Mu have come through a hard battle here against the Malaysian pair. This the winning point, and it was as close as the match was. Right on the line.
It's close.
Yeah.
Match won by Fang Chieh-min, Lee Sheng Mu, 26-24, 21-19.
Well, they say five game points in that opening game, and then, well, at 19-17 now, they took the final 4 points to come through 21-19. It was a thrilling match, they both.
It was a very good match, just as what we expected. It was fast and furious all the way, and as you said, it was touch and go.
Well, it took them 43 minutes, but the number 10 seeds have come through. little bit of the stats there over the match itself. Anything stick out for you? It's pretty close, like the match was, isn't it?
It is. Very hard to say. But again, the Malaysians are winning on the net winners, 7-3. And that, again, just drives the point of the fact that the Chinese Taipei pair really is driving everything and hitting everything. They don't play these soft shots into the net and giving themselves opportunity.
It's Fang and Li through to round three.